The tools we use in the mastering stage are not too different from what we already know of from the mixing stage. For example, when it comes to equalization, we use something called a linear phase EQ. In FL Studio, we're still going to use the parametric EQ2, which has a linear phase option. When it comes to compression, we're going to make use of Maximus, which is a multiband compressor. With the multiband compressor, we get more micro adjustments, so the compression will sound a bit more transparent. All right, so now it's time to finish up the track with some mastering.
All right, now we're ready for mastering this song. I'm going to make sure that the audio is routed through the mixer. I'll double click the clip here and click over here. So now we're automatically routed to mixer insert number 5. I'm going to play back from somewhere over here. This is the loudest part of the track. And as you can see, the audio is being routed to mixer insert number 5. And now we can go ahead and add the mastering processors on the effects slots over here. I'm going to start with an EQ. Now, in the mixing stage, we've used an equalizer to balance individual elements in a mix. Here, we're now going to use the equalizer to balance the overall mix, or the entire track. To make this process a bit more transparent, we will enable this linear phase mode. Without going into too much detail, linear phase equalization is recommended during the mastering stage because it will give us a more transparent result without negatively affecting the overall sound. All right, so I'm going to play the track a little bit. We can see in the frequency analyzer the various frequencies in the entire track. I want to tone down some of this excessive low end here, so I'm going to right click this token and switch to high pass mode. Now that sounds a bit too thin, we're losing some bass, so I'll pull it back. Let's set it around 30 Hz, and let's also change the order from 2 to 4, so it's a little bit more steep. I'll play that section again. So we still have some low end, but not too much of the excessive low end. I feel some of the mid frequencies are a little too bright, so let's tone this down over here. This is a subtle reduction, about 2 dB reduction here. I want to brighten some of the highs, so let's use the shelving EQ to brighten up all the high frequencies above 5,270 Hz. Again, I'm going for a very subtle amount, just 2 dB. At the mastering stage, you do not want to be adding too much of a gain or too much of a dip. It needs to be very, very subtle. All right, let's compare this to the un-EQ'd version. If I click over here, we go back to the original un-EQ'd version. And now let's switch back to the EQ version. So yes, a very, very subtle overall change, and I'm fairly happy with the overall frequency response of this track. All right, the next thing I want to add is a compressor, specifically a multiband compressor. So I'm going to load in Maximus. So just like the regular compressor, Maximus compresses or reduces the dynamic range of the incoming audio signal, but it has 3 different frequency bands. We have a low frequency band, so a compressor just focusing on the low frequencies, another one just focusing on the mids, another one just focusing on the highs. And then we have a 4th compressor that affects the entire audio signal. So multiband compression is also recommended at the mastering stage to give you a bit more of a transparent result. If I click over here, we can see how the 3 different bands are being divided. And of course, we can adjust this. So let's say I want to focus more on the lower frequencies for the low band. Let's say I set it to around 100 Hz. And on the higher end, I want to focus a little bit on the higher end. Let's say closer to 4000 Hz. All right, so let's focus on the low compressor first. I can even hit the solo button here, and we can just listen to the low frequencies. Right now, nothing is being compressed. Unlike the fruity limiter, this compressor works a little differently. We have a transfer function here, an X and Y axis. So on the X axis, we have the incoming audio signal, and on the Y axis, we have the output. So based on this graph, you can see here, if any signal reaches the 0 dB point, it is completely leveled out. In other words, no signal is allowed to go above 0 decibels. All right, so I'm going to bring that lower so we can start to compress it earlier. Still not much compression, but I can increase this pre-gain here to increase the incoming audio signal that's going into the compressor. And let's bring this a little bit lower. And now you can see the compression. If I wanted to limit the signal, I can bring this line down here. So the signal never crosses this threshold. But I don't want such extreme compression, so I'm gonna move it back up just for a subtle amount here. Let's unsolo it. Now to save time, I've gone ahead and made changes to all the individual bands as well as the master band, and this is the final result. All right, now let's talk about stereo widening. We have a feature over here where we can add stereo separation on individual bands. So let's say on the low band, if I solo this, when I move the knob to the left, we're adding more stereo separation. So the sound is gonna be a bit wider. Generally, low frequencies, you want them to be mono. So I'm gonna move this to the right here, merge the low frequencies, so we get a more mono result on the low end. Let's switch to the mids. We could add a little bit of stereo separation here. Again, very subtle amount. And on the highs, I'll add a little bit more. So we get some nice stereo width on the higher frequencies. Let's unsolo and have a listen. All right, so let's again listen with everything off. And I'll turn it on now. All right, so I'm happy with that result. Now in this template, on the master track, we do have a limiter sitting here on the very last slot. So let's make use of the limiter to just ensure that the signal never crosses the 0 dB point. And we can see here, we're fairly safe. I'm gonna add a little bit more gain, just to add a bit more loudness to the track. I'm actually going to bring the ceiling down ever so slightly. So now the signal doesn't even reach the 0 dB mark. It is limited at negative 0.5 decibels. All right, so I'm happy with all the processing. One final thing I do want to take care of is a fade in the beginning of the track and a fade out. So the track already kind of fades in. But I want to make sure that that's a bit more obvious. So I'm going to adjust the fade over here. Let's have a listen to that. So we have a bit more of a gradual fade in there. And lastly, towards the end of the track, I don't need all the silence at the end, so I'm gonna pull this back here, and I'm gonna ensure that we have a nice fade out as well. Let's zoom in here and also adjust the curve of the fade out. All right, so that is the entire track. I'm done with the mastering stage and now I can export this. I'm gonna go to File here and go to Export and let's create an MP3 file. I'll save this as Song 1 Mastered. I want a high quality MP3, so I leave the bitrate at 320 kbps. All the other settings I'm gonna leave as is. Hit Start. And now we will have an MP3 version of this track. So that is the entire process of mastering a song.
Thank you.